Families of two people killed in an overnight shooting are remembering their loved ones. It happened in an area that has recently seen an increase in crime. WLWT News 5's Kyla Woods has that story.
Shots rang out in the early morning hours right here in this parking lot in Winton Hills, leaving two people dead. Police are working right now to find out who did this and why.
He's a nice guy. My brother, I love him to death.
On the eve of what should have been a celebration, Jean Leary now has to make funeral plans for her brother, John Martin, who would have turned 39 years old tomorrow. He and 29-year-old Brandy Fields were found dead in a car this morning from apparent gunshot wounds. The news came as a complete shock when she received a phone call that would change her life.
And he said, "Have you heard?" And I said, "No." So he told me what happened to my brother, that him and the girl had got killed.
We spoke to Captain Paul Newdegate with District 5, and he confirmed that the Cincinnati Metropolitan Housing Authority previously funded daily police patrols in the area, and that when the effort was cut 2 months ago, there was a significant spike in activity and, as a result, an increase in homicides. As police continue to gather information, several questions remain. Were the victims residents in the area? Were they visiting? And what motive would someone have to commit this crime? And we'll continue to bring you the latest information on our website at WLWT.com. Reporting from Winton Hills, I'm Kyla Woods, WLWT News 5.
Now, police have not released any suspect information in this case, and so far they have not made any arrests.